Go.
How you doing, guys, and welcome to another video. And I wasn't planning to do a video and I didn't even put my mic on, so you're listening to the inbuilt audio, but I really wanted to get this video out for the EOS M people. And you know, if you watch my video on the HD streaming adapter and how it can turn your Android phone into a DSLR monitor, you know, that video was amazing and I think it's been well received. But you know, it's time to step it up a notch now, because I've been playing with the app all day and there's just been some amazing things I've discovered. Now, firstly, I want to talk about the app, and I've actually gone and found another app. The camera file was all right. You know, it did a lot of things, but the YouTube stream and the Facebook stream, and I couldn't get it to work for myself. And it's one thing that I wanted to try, but I couldn't get it to work. And then I found the app a bit cluttered as well. Too many things on the screen and you know, the ads and all that kind of stuff. And I'm not going to purchase it because it's only an app I'm going to use every now and again. And I have a field monitor. So I wanted something that is, you know, that's free, that's capable, and that does the job. So the app which I found was called OTG View. Now, this app I found, I think it's a lot cleaner on the interface. And, you know, it's just so much easier to use. So let's just open this app now, and I'm going to show you what I found and why I'm going to continue to use this app. Right, so here's the app, and you can see I've got it connected to the EOS M, and the EOS M is running Magic Lantern. And now, yes, you can see the screen is quite small here, and it's actually not much bigger than the normal screen, but we'll get into that in a second. First of all, I want to go through the these functions here at the top, these buttons here. So the first button is called the split screen mode. So as you can see, it splits the screen. Now, the one on the right is actually a snapshot of what we're looking at, and the one on the left, as you can see with the audio meter is going up, is the live view. Absolutely fantastic this is, and you're going to need this mode, and I'll show you why soon. But as you can see, if you wanted to say you was taking a shot and you had to move your camera or whatever, or change battery, and you wanted to, you know, reframe it exactly the same, you've got the exact same shot here which you had from last time. So as you can see, even though the camera's gone off, the app still keeps the same framing and picture. So you could change batteries and then reframe, and then you're good to go. So now if I just hit the button here, there you go, we're good to go. Absolutely amazing. And I'm going to show you why you're going to need this as well, because you can see all the information here and you're going to need that in a second, but I'll show you, we'll get to that. And the second button here is what it hides all of the icons here. So if I press that again, you can see the icons come out. And if you press it, you see they disappear. Now, these icons are absolutely amazing because, again, you can take a snapshot. If you're doing a scene and then you're going to come back the next day, you can actually take a photograph of whatever the camera sees, so then you can frame up the next day and you've got the exact same look. You know, absolutely amazing. Also, you've got the video here. So imagine if you wanted to take some, I don't know, some BTS, but you only had your EOS M on you. You didn't want to change it into, you know, normal 1080 or whatever. You could just hit this button here and record your BTS, and it's recording what the EOS M Magic Lantern sees. So if you've got some, you know, some nice filters on there, your ND filter is perfectly tuned, and you know, you've got your, I don't know, your Tiffin Pro Mist, it's going to look pretty much the same as what you've got coming in the camera. So then you can just quickly edit that on your phone if you wanted to, then upload that straight to Insta. It's absolutely amazing. Next one down, we've got, so we've got our gallery. So the gallery, we can go through and look at, you know, any snapshots we've got or any video we've taken. And then the next button here we've got is your resolution list. So this is your recording resolution list. So when you're recording your videos and stuff like that, change your resolution, and you've got, you know, whatever kind of resolution you want. I've gone for 1920 by 1080, and it works well. The last button there, do not touch that last button. It's a shame that that doesn't work, because sometimes when I've looked at a scene, the scene looks so oversaturated on the phone through the app than what's coming through on the EOS M. But I found that this will just break the footage. It just looks like it's been inverted, and I tried to tweak it to get it back and press the reset button, but it doesn't work. So for now, just leave that alone. Okay, don't use it. And now I want to show you why you're going to need this split screen mode. So if I go back into normal mode, you can see we've got the small screen. Now, to get this screen bigger, I need to tap the settings, tap display mode, tap full screen, and then back out of here. And now you can see we've got a much bigger screen to work with for pulling our focus and, you know, getting everything framed up nicely. But as you can see, we can't see none of the info buttons, none of the ISO, what we're working at, etc. So if you wanted to quickly change your ISO and you wanted to know obviously what ISO you're on, just hit the snapshot button. There you can see all the information. Then you can quickly change your ISO using your buttons on the EOS M, and then just come straight back out. And then you're back in again. Absolutely amazing app. And as you can see, there's no ads popping up and no janky bits. It's just very simple. And then obviously if you want it much cleaner, then just tap the hide icons button and they're gone too. Absolutely amazing, guys. So yeah, this was strictly for the EOS M people. How does it work? You know, all that kind of stuff. It works absolutely amazing. If I just hit the record button now to show you how it records. There you go. Looks a bit funky. I've got some lines down here as well. I'm not sure. I think that's probably the way the EOS M is feeding out the HDMI signal. I've tested it already. That doesn't come out in the footage, so we're pretty much good to go. And then if I just stop recording. And then we're back to our normal screen. Guys, that's all I've got to say on this one. This app just keeps on giving and giving and giving. I'm going to try the CameraFi app again because I still want to see if I can live stream with the EOS M to Facebook and YouTube. YouTube wouldn't let me live stream, and I think it's something to do with the current climate, what's going on, that they're limiting live streams. But this app and this HD device will literally bring the EOS M back into 2020, because the EOS M was left off the list when Canon updated, when they released the streaming app that you can use your mirrorless camera to stream, or your DSLR, but obviously the EOS M is too old, it wasn't in there. But with this HD device, you can just, get ready to go stream on your EOS M. It's absolutely crazy. So guys, thanks for that. Hope you enjoyed the video, and any questions, let me know. I'll speak to you on the next one. Bye.